Hey, football season's back, so we're going to talk about the huddle right now on The Front.
Thanks for tuning in to Lead the Teams, The Front.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of The Front. My name is Mike Phillips, and I'll be your host. As always, you can tune in on leadtheteam.tv. If you do that, you can subscribe right down there in the corner to the video blogs. You can check out the podcast on iHeartRadio, on iTunes, and on Google Play. Also, if you would participate in the discussion down below, please share your comments, share your opinions. Let's have a discussion. Often that leads to a really excellent future show. So today I'm talking about leadership and actually leadership sometimes from the middle of an organization. I was talking with a team of people this week because, and for me, I'm getting ahead of myself. Football's back, right? And I am a huge football fan. We're a football family. And I know it's still preseason right now, but football's here. So that's the most important message that you should get out of today. Actually, that's not really the most important message, but it's important to me. I'm excited about it. And I love the analogies and the comparisons that professional sports has to business, especially football. For me, from the coaching, the leadership, both on the sidelines and on the field and the locker room, all of the things that seem to coincide for me between professional sports, real true professional athletes, and business. And so I was coaching a team of individuals this week, and one of my favorite lines, I think this was come up with some years ago, and I was speaking with them, I looked them dead in the eye, and I said, listen, and we're talking about performance in business. And the discussion was, it is time for you to step up, right? You know what needs to be done. And you got to ask everybody, if you're in a leadership role, first off, do you know what needs to be done? And most people, if they've been in your charge for 30, 60, 90 days or more, in most positions in sales, in BDC, automotive, that sort of deal, most people know what needs to be done, and most people know how to achieve it, or at least to start on the path. And so it's our job as leaders to bring that out of them and help groom it and help, you know, get the machete out and cut the path and help them start down it. And so I was having a discussion with this group of people, and I said, so everyone here, you know what needs to be done. There's a bunch of heads nodding. Oh, yeah, absolutely. We know what needs to be done. The next statement, and it just came out and it was pretty profound. The comment is, I said, well, if that's the case, then it's time to execute. It's time to do the job. It's time to make the calls. It's time to make the out dials. It's time to set the appointments. Time to start making the magic happen for yourself, because I'll give you a tip. In a football game, the coach isn't in the huddle. They may be on the sidelines screaming your name in vain, throwing down the clipboard. When it comes game time, when it's time to actually perform, at that point, it's up to the players. At that point, it's up to the frontline staff to execute, right? And so as I was explaining this to them and we're talking, I said, hey, one of the most, I don't know that I want to say critical, but one of the most just awesome things that then my team went forward to execute on as I was going to be out in the afternoon. They said, okay, here's what we're going to do. We're going to formulate a plan and we're going to call some signals back to you, coach, as to what we're going to do to have just a killer remainder of the month. And so that afternoon when I showed back up, all lined out on my desk, nice and neat, were, you know, 20, maybe 30, actually, probably closer to 30 actionable items from my team that they said, here's what we're going to do. Here was our huddle. Here's our huddle talk, coach. Now, here's the deal. Get out of the way and watch this. You need to allow us the opportunity to execute. And so one of the things that can be tough sometimes for leaders and managers is you have to, if your team is willing to step up in that fashion and they say, okay, we've got the reins, we've got the play, coach, here's the offensive play. We're going to flea flicker left. Left. My left is your right now. But if they say, we're going to do this flea flicker play, just get out of the way and watch this. Here it comes. And you have to be willing as a coach, as a leader, as a manager, to let go of the reins for a minute, to fold the playbook up, and just watch and allow your team to execute on what they've been trained to do. And that, my friends, can be a really tough thing for me. I can only speak for myself, but I know other type A personalities in that leadership role, sometimes that can be a tough thing to do. If you have that faith and that confidence in your people, you also have to remind yourself that as a coach, you're not in the huddle on the field. And sometimes a quarterback, sometimes a key player has got to call an audible, and you may be calling the play from the sideline and saying, okay, here's what I think we need to do, but you're not the one that's lined up shoulder to shoulder with those people on the field. So as they're lined up shoulder to shoulder and they're looking straight ahead at someone, they're going, holy heck, we've got to move. We've got to change. Everybody shift one this way. So that is my only message for the day, for both really actionable players, you know, those staff members, those high level people that are, you want to perform, you want to grow, you want to just crush it. And it's also my message for the leaders that tune into my podcasts and the videos, is you got to remember that the coach isn't in the huddle. So as a player, huddle up, get your teammates rallied, those people that you're in there shoulder to shoulder with executing every day. You have to have their back as much as they have theirs. And sometimes it's more powerful coming from a peer. If your peer looks at you and says, hey, I'm getting my butt kicked, you need to man up or woman up and block that person. You need to man up or woman up and execute on what you said, because I'm getting tattooed back here. I'm not able to accomplish what I need to accomplish because you're failing to execute on your task. Sometimes that peer pressure, that positive peer pressure, can carry a much heavier weight than the coach throwing the clipboard down on the sideline, than the manager threatening the write-up saying, hey, listen, if you don't get this job done, you know, you've got that peer level accountability that is sometimes really, really powerful. And then, as I mentioned, for the leaders and the managers, when you're in that role, you have to remember that your people are trained. They're ready. If you've done your job up to that point and your crew is trained, ready, and knows how to execute, you got to let off them and give them the opportunity. Don't micromanage your people. Let them execute the best play. Let them execute the items that are the best thing right now for your business. And if you expect excellence and you treat them like champions, guess what? They'll produce excellence and they'll behave like champions. So that's my message for today. Thank you so much for tuning in to another episode of The Front. Remember, I do this every Wednesday and Sunday. Hope you got some value out of it. As I said before, please participate in the comments. Share it. That's one of the reasons that I do this, is I really want to make a positive impact on sales, and especially automotive sales in the automotive industry. If you get some value out of this, please share it with your friends and coworkers and anybody that you think would get some value out of these videos or podcasts. So thank you again. My name is Mike Phillips, another episode of The Front, and I will see you next Wednesday. Hope you have a fantastic day.